You want an AC70 ACE, Derek? Nice. Yeah, they are. They're another one that looks different and interesting, aren't they? G44 ton of hype. Right, Brakeman, we have several set outs and pickups to make here on the branch this morning. We will be responsible for our manual switches. As our first move, proceed ahead and stop at the harbour lead, and then we'll reverse into harbour yard. So we're here. We are actually all points set up, ready to go. Yeah, the 101 is probably one of my favourite at the moment in TS World. These things got a really interesting backstory, the GE44s. So at the time the GE44s were going to be made, there was a rule in place because the firemen from steam engine days were concerned that their jobs were going to be gone. So there was a rule put in place by the unions that anything 45 tons or over had to have a second person in the crew. So they made a switcher that was 1 ton lighter than that, so they didn't have to do that. Lear is beautiful, isn't it? I really enjoy driving that one as well. It sort of nails that commuter train atmosphere. The brakes on the 45, they're just standard self-lapping air brakes, CG. I think the fact that the 45 can do both, it's dual, I think. Ed can confirm. But in terms of everything you'd use it for on that route, it's air. Second road in. Ed, are you still about? Or have you fallen asleep? Ed is still about. CG, explain what you're seeing. And then Ed can tell you why it's right. Right, a couple. We'll be delivering these loads to the Fairhaven power plant, but also some empties to pull at the plant. Proceed to and stop at Harbour Lee, where we'll temporarily spot and uncouple from these five. I'm not sure actually, Sprint Truck, don't know. G'day, Emma. You haven't left the brakes on the other cab, have you, CG? That needs to be set to handle off. Weaky wimpy this thing is. Alex, thank you very much for the cheers. Have a great night to you. Right, now pull forward, stop at the power plant lead. Anyone can submit scenario packs for Steam release like this. So this is a workshop scenario, Danderman. But if you want to publish a scenario pack via Steam, you need to contact the third party team. How long are you going to be around for, CG? Take it. I'm going to grab those three. Yeah, please do, Sprinter. Right, we're now ready to reverse into New Haven Fairhaven Power Plant and couple into three empty hoppers. No, I didn't even have a chance to look at the Christmas stuff on Truck Sim. Well, I'm just thinking after this scenario, CG, I could fire up TransPennine and we can have a quick look. Right, pull forward, stop a power plant lead with the rear clear of the siding switch. Back these up and put them back on the others. Couple up and pull forward the power plant lead. Oh, and they're going to put those five back in there. Got you. Right, reverse and recouple the five loaded hoppers. Whoops. I did get that just in time. Steering axle trailer. Oh, I love those. They are a revolution. Dun-dun-dun. Right, spot the five loaded hoppers at the power plant. Reluctant to move. If so, reversing isn't easy to know. It's just something you get used to, Ben, to be honest. It's like I've been using, the last two or three times I played it over the weekend, I've been doing it all in VR, and it took me a bit to get used to be honest. Because there is no external view or anything like that. You're entirely, in fact, it's almost, it's awkward to look out and just look backwards, so you're entirely reliant on your mirrors. But I got the hang of it. At least as, you know, as good as I've ever done it. Right, we can now spot on a couple of five hoppers at the power plant. Good evening, Rob. Looking forward to Trains in World Northern Trans North Trans Pennine in an hour. Excellent. Sinuses woke you up at 5 o'clock this morning. Oh, that's not good, Moggy. That is not good. Right, pull forward, stop at power plant lead with the rear clear for the move to Harbour Yard. Back to there and drop those in road one. Go the right way. We make a make much more strides in the right direction. Yard track one. I guess we're going to get those tankers next. There's a caboose at the end of this this track. That seems a bit suspicious, so I'm going to roll up a bit closer to it. Pull forward, stop at harbour short your lead, anticipation of a reverse move into track 3 where we get the tank car. So harbour short lead is next. I really like this little GE44. I've always liked it. I think it'd be quite an interesting loco to build into Train Sim World as well. You enjoying the 33, Rob? Excellent. Glad you're enjoying it. Back and get to the 5 tanks. The 33 was only released last week, I think, or the week before. On PS4. January, there you go. Right, moving these oil cars to oil terminal. Pull forward, stop at harbour lead. With the rear clear for a move to oil terminal 2. This oil terminal 2 is back here somewhere, yeah. Got it up to 7 miles an hour. The question is, will I be able to stop it? Get the rear car past the scissors. Over the 101, don't give you too many problems. You should be fine, Derek. D-pad up, D-pad down to change gears. Make sure the RPM counter is sufficiently low before you you change gears, otherwise it won't take. Otherwise than that, the brakes manually lapped. It takes a little bit getting used to, but otherwise than that, it's fine. Bit of practice is all it takes on the 101. Alright, so switch the scissors over. Comes around there. I need to go into oil terminal 2, which is that one and that one. Yep. Reverse, we'll spot and uncouple from the 5 tank cars. Oh, it's not too bad. 15 out of 24. We're over halfway. We're over halfway. Nearly there. Good night, Moggy. Stay well, mate. All these into place. Get 4 tank cars. from Terminal 3, so it's those ones we're going to go and get. Get boxcars from there. Get the three empty hoppers there. Couple them to the caboose. Park them. So, once this one is delivered, we're basically on the last moves. Pull forward to short lead. Thank you for the cheer, striker number 9. Right, and then we're going to go back to that one, and that one. Gets us into water terminal 3. Right, make a switching move so we can have the two box cars. So one's just over around the corner there. Oh, there they are, over there, those two. I'll actually take them on a 4 mile run. In this thing. Change that switch. Oop, just activated physics on the box cars. Right, we're now ready to hook back onto the three empty hoppers and our caboose and make the run to Cedar Hill. Go to the harbour lead. Box cars. It is a 1950s route, Ben. If I remember rightly. Well, there or thereabouts, anyway. New York, New Haven and Hartford Railroad hasn't been around for a long time. Hey Alex Media, how are you doing? Yeah, not doing bad at all, not doing bad at all. Right, that puts me back into track one. Thank you all. Thank you all. Right, reverse and get them. Go get them. Almost knees and you get to take tomorrow off work. Got too much to do. Got too much cool stuff to do.
Besides, if three sneezes meant I didn't have to go to work, I'd never go to work.
I tend to sneeze in at least sixes. Now reverse further, couple onto the caboose number 536. Right, time to call a dispatch for clearance. Engineer Mill River branch local to New Haven Terminal. Dispatcher, our work is done on the branch. We're ready to depart the harbour yard and proceed to Cedar Hill. I'll check with the yard master and he'll be yarding you at Cedar Hill Maybrook Receiving Yard. He'll be contacting you with further details. As of 9:40 a.m. or later, we're only 3 minutes late, you have permission to pull from Harbour Yard and, subject to signal indications, enter the main line at Mill River Junction. Proceed via the airline junction. Dispatch out. Right. That's there, so we're currently parked there. And we're parked there. Too early to tell about that. Come on. Yeah, move on. Just up here, out of the yard. Good night, Wackaday. We'll run down this place. Alright, we're coming up to our first signal. Given how long this thing is going to take to stop. Looks like we're good, we've got a yellow on the bottom. Be yarded at Cedar Hill, New York Maybrook, receiving 6, and you can leave the power attached. You may need to call for a signal as you approach Cedar Hill, and also ensure your manual switches to a line for receiving track 6. (sighs) 2 miles now. Side of a light, yeah. Just half a mile away though. There's a receiving yard lead coming up ahead. Like two reds on that signal, but I think that's the one they said to tab. Like a piggyback truck over there.
Think about trains, right? Prepared to stop even if I don't think I'm going to need to. That signal's a mess, isn't it? That one that's granting us permission to go through the little dwarf. It's not letting me tab, so. Oh, what a time, Ben. There's so much good stuff to run. No, I think the whole point of intermodal is they don't need to carry the trailer. Just take the container off the trailer, put it on the train, and you've got less weight that less bulk weight there. You've just got the container and not all the trailer nonsense. Plus, you can obviously double stack them as well. Mile to go. Pretty much this yard. Themes are a good idea, as Sprinter says. Pick a theme. Do a different theme a different day, that we can sort of pick diesels, pick modern, pick electric, pick shunting, pick express trains, pick steam engines, pick big steam engines, little steam engines. You know, write down all the possible things you can do, and you could always just roll a dice until you find out which one you want to do. Trunkles, what are TS and TSW written in? C++. Visual Studio 2015, I think. Actually, no, that's probably on 17 now as well. I think they're both on 2017.
in most games these days. Yeah, Visual Studio's been around a long time, CG Life. Well, Microsoft generally just copy other people's ideas, Drunkles, to be fair. One of my former colleagues at a previous workplace described them as, I can't remember what exact words were, but the world's best reinventors. They take an idea and they'll do something great with it, but they're not so good at the actual first idea. Yeah, I'll do some of your new stuff then, Ben. Yeah, Top Speed was a bit before my time, I remember it, but I didn't know C++ back in those days. I was teaching myself BASIC and Pascal and then Delphi, and I didn't hit C++ until I got Turbo C++. Are you new Straustrup? Don't rate him, clearly. Alright, we've got to stop it on a pinhead at the end of the siding. Oh, the 506 is great, isn't it? Why don't I beat it, Ben? But it is worth learning to drive 76, so that's really good. That's alright, Clawzorg, we're tolerant and accepting. How's it going? Tops, we were all ex-Borland. Oh, nice. Right, well done, you brought the tonnage from Mill River. I'll take a well-deserved break. Yay. Right, now, CG, are you still there? If so, what is it that you would do? What scenario or service should I play to do what you